Today we decided to pay tribute to some amazing dads. We have had letters, well, from all over our emails and things like that, but we got a letter from a dad who is actually a stay-at-home mom. And I thought this letter was so sweet because, you know, the roles of parent are kind of switching now. You know, moms are working, dads are home, things like this. But I thought this is so cool. It's from a guy named Michael. It says, "Hi, Marie. My name is Michael Prather. I'm from Acworth, Georgia, and I'm writing to share, I'm writing to share with you the joy," and he puts in parentheses, "and sacrifice of being a stay-at-home dad. Our son Spencer is 4 weeks old. My wife Jean is attending nursing school during the day. We simply do not want to put our son in daycare at such a young age, or even if we can ever help to do it. Although this is the toughest job I've ever done," I love him for that statement, "it is the most gratifying. I think every man should have to go through this at least once in his life.
Absolutely.
Sincerely, Michael." Isn't that a great letter?
You know what?
I love that letter.
I accept everything he said in there. Every man should just try to do what their partners do. They'd be totally surprised. As you know, we do this show from Los Angeles. And I go home on the end of the week, and I jump in, and I try to do as much as I can to help Debbie's load. And I am just thoroughly exhausted with what she does. I just hope she never gets a television talk show job. I'd have to put the dress on, you know. But you know what amazes me? This is the amazing thing. I don't know how she does it.
Yeah.
No, think about this. You're doing Debbie's job and my job. I don't know how you do it.
Well.
No, seriously.
You know.
Because,
you know what, sincerely, Donny? Sincerely, you know, we are surrounded with great people that help us.
Yeah.
I really am just so admirable for the women out there who are being single parents and don't have the support. So my heart goes out to all of you. Happy Father's Day.
Yeah.
You deserve it.
I have to say.
You deserve it. I have another letter, though.
Before you get the letter, I have to say one thing. I am a pretty good Mr. Mom.
Yeah, you are. He is a good Mr. Mom.
When I go home, I'm cleaning, laundry, go Mr. Mom. Vacuuming. I need work in certain areas like cooking, dressing the baby this weekend, dressing the baby.
Yeah, but I need to get to...
Can I just tell you this one story? Can I just say this one story?
Do we have time for this story? We don't.
We don't have time? I'm going to tell you anyway. It's my show.
No, but we don't have time. You know what? I let me just read one more and then you tell us the story, okay?
All right.
This, I just, so we can get off the emails. This is from a kid. It says, "Happy Father's Day. I wish I could be there to wish you Happy Father's Day in person. I'd love to try to embarrass you on national TV, but since I can't, I figured I'd write you a letter instead. If asked what I admired most about you, I'd have to say that I love the fact that you're a party animal. I also love the fact that you enjoy a good laugh and always take pleasure in making me laugh. I miss you so much. I want to let you know that I love you very much, and I hope that I can live up to the name that we both share. Happy Father's Day. I'll see you in August." That's from your son, Don. And you know what? How can you work on Father's Day? We have a surprise for you. Come on down. Turn around.
No.
And there she is.
Okay, I'm crying.
Oh.
You guys, come over here and sit on the couch. Come on, everybody over here.
Oh, great.
Come on, come over here. Come on. Hi, Deb.
Jimmy. I've been trying to call you all day, Brandon. And you didn't answer the phone.
I know.
You're on a plane.
Oh, this is so fun. I love surprises. Gotcha.
Oh, that's great.
All right, you guys, what is the greatest thing? What's the greatest thing about this guy?
Everything. Everything is great about him. There's
his cooking.
Well, he's what?
His cooking.
My cooking.
What's the silliest thing your dad's ever done, Brandon?
I don't know.
There really isn't one that we can.
He does.
There's
lots.
Too many.
Yes.
He does lots.
Is it weird having a celebrity father? Is he? Does he act like that?
No, he's.
He's
no.
an idiot, isn't he?
Yes.
You know, just so you guys know, this is Joshua. That's my wife, Debbie, as you know. That's Jeremy and Christopher and Brandon.
What did you do to your arm?
I broke my collarbone.
You broke your collarbone?
Yeah, he was trying to jump a motorbike the other day.
Yeah.
I got to tell you a story that happened to me and Deb this last weekend. You know, like I said, I'm a good, pretty good Mr. Mom.
Is he a good Mr.
Yes,
Mom?
Yes, he is.
Except when it comes, and there's my son, Don. He's over in England right now.
That's the one who wrote the letter.
Yeah.
He's on a mission.
You see, like I said, I can do the laundry.
He can do the laundry. He's great at laundry. He's a horrible cook.
But the other day, Debbie and I were going to go out to dinner, and she said, dress the baby, give him a bath, dress the baby. And I said, no problem. I can do it in 2 minutes, and I did. I come back out of the bathroom, dress the baby, and Debbie comes out of the closet, and she falls on the floor laughing. And she says, honey, what planet were you born on? And I said, what's the problem? Look at the baby. An orange plaid shirt, blue striped pants, and Winnie the Pooh slippers.
Yeah. And he was dressed.
He was dressed.
And I said, Debbie said, we're going to dinner, not Cirque du Soleil. You know? I thought it was great because you get the food on the clothes. You would never see
it. Do you have
a
funny imitation of him? Does somebody, one of you guys do a funny imitation?
There's one. When he used to get mad, or when he does get mad. When he gets mad, he does this lower voice thing. It's, children?
Children?
Real firm.
Do it again.
Children?
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 Or just Jeremy.
Jeremy?
Yeah, that's it.
That's it?
Jeremy?
Oh, it's so fun. Hey, you guys, we're going to go to commercial. And we're gonna be right back after this. It's so fun to have you all here. Were you surprised?
Oh, absolutely.
Always surprises on Donny and Marie. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this. Thank Bill Engelmark, Long, Larry Flax, and Rick Rosenfield from California Pizza Kitchen, and of course, my sister-in-law, Debbie. We have Jeremy, Brandon, Christopher, and Joshua, and also Don in London with the letter.
Also, everybody in the audience got California Pizza Kitchen. All right.
Have a great day, you guys.
Have a great Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
All right. Happy Father's Day, Father.
Monday on Donny and Marie. From Cheers bartender to Becker's MD, it's Ted Danson. Also from dark days to lighthearted laughs, actress Margot Kidder.